Okay, I'm going to show you now the difference between checking a whole crate, trying to check a whole crate of strawberries versus one or two individual punnets. Because with a large metal detector, the bigger the metal detector gets, the worse the sensitivity gets. So it can only detect larger items. And just for the purpose of this test, when we validate a metal detector, we always use a ball bearing test piece. And these test pieces here are ferrous, non-ferrous, and stainless steel. Stainless steel would replicate the material that a needle is made of, so that's the one we really want to focus on. But if we were validating this metal detector with a whole crate of strawberries, which is about 7 kilos, you can see just here, this is a whole crate of 250 gram punnets. And these, with this metal detector, we can validate it that we can find a 5 millimeter piece of stainless steel. And the thing with a metal detector that's really important to understand is that if you're looking for something like a needle, and I have here an example of a sewing needle, typical sewing needle, that one's cut in half, one's full. Depending which, the reason we don't use pieces of metal like this to check a metal detector is because depending which way it goes through the metal detector will give you a totally different signal. And from testing I've done, and I'll show you in the video, if the needle is going through lengthways or close to lengthways, it no problem detecting either half or a full needle. If the needle is that way, so a half needle that way, or even vertical like that, then you struggle to find a full needle and definitely won't find a half needle, not in a whole crate of strawberries. If you're doing one or even two punnets, we can find both of those no matter what position they are oriented in. So this is really important before you decide what metal detector you're going to deploy for finding contaminants like this, because you could just be totally wasting your money, and that's regardless of which type of metal detector you buy. All metal detectors have the same type of technology. So anyway, I'll show you. This is the program for a whole crate of berries. You can see here, I'll put it through. So the whole crate, it says pass. Now if I put it through with a round test piece of stainless steel, like I said, that's it doesn't matter which way I put that in, because it's going to give the same signal every time. Put it through with 5 millimeters of stainless steel, you can see it triggered a fail. Our fail limit is actually anything above the value of 2.0. Now, for purpose of demonstration with the needle, if I put a full needle through, orientated lengthways, and you can see there, just do a close-up of the where it is in the punnet, that's where it is. So we put that through lengthways. You can see quite a large signal there compared to that 5 millimeter test piece. Now, let me put that needle through crossways, exactly perpendicular to what we did just before. Exactly the same needle. You can see there, that's actually passed. So that is the difference between putting it through lengthways and crossways. Now, if I put it in a vertical orientation, I'm just going to tuck it in there between the punnets vertically. Okay, no problem. So the worst orientation was this way, crossways. So obviously you've got no control over which way the needle contamination, if someone's put it in there, is going to be. So you just need to be mindful of that restriction. I'll just put through the half needle now in a lengthways position. Again, we can detect that, no problem. I'll put that in a vertical orientation. That passed, so you can't find it in a vertical orientation, and I'll put it through in a crossways orientation, which you won't be able to detect either. The half needle. There you can see it virtually didn't even notice that there was anything in there. So that's really important to understand. Like I said, 5 millimeter stainless steel is what we can certainly validate this to, but with a needle, depending which way you look at it, it's certainly less than 5 millimeters in cross section. But when it's that way, it's more than 5 millimeters. So that's the random nature of metal detection, and very important to understand. Now, if I go to I've saved a product profile here for individual punnets. So just to give you a comparison, for individual punnets, I've just loaded a program, which you can see here, or you can pre-program this machine for different sizes, but this is for just an individual punnet, as opposed to the previous program, which was a whole box of strawberries. So now when I run an individual punnet, if I put through the one punnet, you can see there, that's passed. If I put through the full needle in a lengthways configuration, that's a massive signal. I'll put through the same needle in a cross orientation, crossways. No problems detecting that. And obviously vertical would be okay. I'll just go straight to the half needle, both in lengthways. That's lengthways and a half needle. Let's sandwich it between two punnets. So this, if you look down here, this is a half needle crossways, which is the worst position it can be, sandwiched between two punnets of berries. Okay, we can find that, no problem. So really important to understand, the more fruit you have, the bigger the product effect and the worse the detection sensitivity gets. So that's really important. So that's with our really large aperture metal detector. I'll show you the same thing with a punnet on a smaller metal detector, which gets even more accurate. Okay, just as a comparison with the larger metal detector, when people are doing individual punnets, they would normally use this size, which is a much smaller metal detector. You can see immediately the belt is narrower, the aperture is smaller. It's designed for smaller, lighter packs. And it's also more accurate and more sensitive. So we can find, as a rule of thumb, smaller stuff on this than we can on the really large format one. So as an example, we've programmed this for a single punnet, exactly the same as we did on the other large metal detector. And if I validate this metal detector, instead of a 5mm test piece stainless steel, we can find a 3.5mm test piece of stainless steel. So that's how much better. It's probably 30-40% more precise than the larger aperture one. So as a demonstration here, I'll put through the good punnet. You can see that just goes through by itself. That's a pass. And excuse me for crossing the camera, but I'll put through with a 3.5mm stainless steel test piece. And that obviously detects that without too much trouble. Now, let's go back to the needles. The exact same needle samples that we used before. Exactly the same punnet of strawberries. A full needle in a lengthways orientation. We knew that wasn't a problem before, so let's put it through this one, and you'll see that the signal is off the scale. Let's go straight to what was the most difficult on the larger aperture metal detector, and that's a half of a needle orientated left to right or crossways. So we put that through. And you can see there, it registered a fail on that. So no problem picking up a half of a needle inside a single punnet. We'll try it with a second punnet as well, just to do an exact like-for-like comparison. So I'm going to put this one actually vertically orientated in this second punnet of strawberries. So that needle is now in a vertical orientation, and we'll put it through the metal detector with a second punnet. And you can see there, we found a fail, no problem at all. So it goes to show again that the product effect on a metal detector certainly comes into play when you're looking for contamination. And that's really, really important to understand when you're testing product or setting up a metal detector or choosing it for the right purpose. Thanks for watching.